Welcome to Nav Classes. If you're new to my channel or viewing my videos for the first time, then please do subscribe and ring the bell with subscribe button to get notified as and when I upload my new video. Today we are going to discuss about blood relation tricks, and here I already covered first class for blood relation and you must have seen that. If you didn't see that, then you can visit the link in description box. And this is the previous lecture in which I taught you we consider man with a box and female with square, circle, sphere, and if they are husband wife, then we put a plus sign, and then if they are sister brother or brother sister or both sister both brother, then we put minus sign, and we denote generation gap with help of this type of arrows, like so. So these are the criterias and basics for that. And one more thing, I already taught you the family tree chart. If you are going to solve any question, then please do make such family tree chart to make to solve any question easily without any hassle. And here is that if you consider yourself as I, then there is your father, your grandfather, and under you there are your children and grandson, daughter, and there are your cousins, brother in your crease. And these are the chart. This is the chart. Just visit that video to be more clarified about this concept. So I already took your test in my Facebook group, in which I think there were 12 questions and maximum score was 9 in that case. So I am discussing those questions and I am telling you how to answer them correctly. So let's start with that. Question number 1 is, a man is pointing to a photograph. It means there is the man who is pointing toward the photograph. The lady in the photograph, there is a lady in the photograph. Let us make this circle for the lady. We consider circle for the lady means female. Is my nephew's maternal grandmother. It means my means man is talking about himself. It means there is the man. We can denote this with help of this box. This man's is my nephew's means man's nephew. Nephew is again male. Then man's nephew, there is generation gap, so you can denote with this arrow. Nephew's maternal grandmother, it means she is grandmother, and that too from her mother's his mother's side. So there must be this is maternal grandmother, so this is the man, and here is the nephew, and the lady is this nephew's maternal grandmother. Okay, so if we see, then there must be a mother of this nephew, because we are talking about maternal grandmother. So let's make another generation gap where there is mother of this nephew. There is mother of this nephew because we are talking about maternal. Then this lady is maternal grandmother, so this here we got this lady as grandmother of this nephew. Okay, and how is he lady in the photograph related to the man's sister who has no other sister. It means this man is having only one sister, man is having no other sister, so it means the sister is real sister. So it means this is the nephew. It means he this nephew is his sister's son. So how this man is related with the lady? If they are brother sister, man and that sister is the brother sister, then this lady will be mother of this sister and this man as well. It means she is mother of this man. So in this manner you draw these all type of family tree chart and answer them. Amit said, this girl is the wife of grandson of my mother. Amit is talking about some girl and he says there is the Amit, girl is wife of grandson of my mother. My mother means Amit's mother, so we draw this mother with help of this pair generation gap. Then this girl is wife of grandson, there must be grandson of that mother, so this is the grandson, and that girl is wife of that grandson. So I denoted this with help of this circle, and there is generation gap like so. So she is the wife and there is grandson. And question is asking about how Amit is related to the girl. If she is wife of grandson of that mother of Amit, then Amit must be a father of that son. Amit must be father of that son. It means if he is father of son, then his wife must be daughter-in-law. Then Amit is father-in-law of that girl. So answer is D here. Amit is father-in-law of that girl. So in this manner, we'll be able to draw this family tree chart and we'll be able to answer this correctly. And then third question is pointing to Ram. Shyam said, I am the only son of the sons of his father. It means there is some person, this is the Shyam, okay? Shyam is saying, I am the only son of the sons of his father. It means sons of Ram's father. So there is Shyam and he is the only son, okay? If we read or if you know the language Hindi, then you can read Hindi as well and you can get the answer easily. But if you know one language, then even then you can use that Shyam is the only son of that person. Okay, it means Ram's only son of one of sons of his father. It means he is talking about Ram's father. So there must be more one or two more sons of Ram's father. It means there can be one more son or two more son or any number of that son. We are not going to consider that. So we can say that I am the only son of one of, means Shyam is only son of out of these son of that person. So Shyam can be son of this person Ram, or Shyam can be son of any other son of that person. So we can say that that person can be father or uncle of Shyam. How Ram is related to Shyam? Ram can be uncle or father of Shyam. So we can say that B is answer. So in this fashion, you can just read the question carefully and try to make that family tree chart, because in this question, all are man. So we denote them all with help of this box. So we got our answer B, father or uncle. Now, among her children, Ganga's favorite Ram and Rekha. And there are, Rekha is mother of Sharad. So let me draw here. I have lesser space, so I am drawing like so. You can draw this in broad manner, wide manner. Okay, so there is Ganga and her children are Ram and Rekha. They are her favorite. Rekha is mother of Sharad. So we made this generation gap with Sharad, who is loved most by his uncle Mithun. It means Mithun is uncle of Rekha. So we can draw generation gap over here. So Rekha is loved most by his uncle Mithun. The head of family is Ramlal. So let we keep Ramlal or Ramlai on the top, and he is the head of family. So we draw like so. Who is succeeded by his son Gopal and Mohan? It means his son are Gopal and Mohan. Gopal and Ganga have been married for 35 years. So this is the quotation over here. So it means Ramlal has only two sons, that is Gopal and Mohan. And Gopal and Ganga are married with each other. So how do we denote married couples? It means husband and wife. We denote them with help of plus sign. So this is the male person and we denote them with plus sign. And Gopal and Ganga are married for 35 years and have three children. What is the relationship between Mohan and Mithun? So there are two children here, Ram and Rekha. So there must be one more child over here. So there, the question is not asking about the another child. So question is asking about the relationship of Mithun and Mohan. So we have to denote this relationship. We know that Ramlal have only two children, that is Mohan and Gopal. So he do not have child that Mithun over here. So Mithun must be the cousin of this Mohan or someone else who is the uncle of Rekha from any relation. So that person can be any person, but he is not real brother of Mohan. This point is clear because this is stated in question that Ramlal have two children, Mohan and Gopal. So that Mithun can be any cousin or anyone else. So this option is not given in this question. So we cannot denote this brother. Some people gave answer brother, but this is wrong. The answer should be no relation. So the answer should be D, no relation, which is not given over here in these options. Okay. That Mithun can be any person, any uncle of Rekha, but he is not his chacha or he is not his any real uncle. So Karan has a brother, Prem. It means there is one Karan and his brother is Prem and sister is Nisha. So let me write down brother. We denote this with help of box and we denote this sister with help of circle, Nisha. So let me write Nisha over here with this circle. Karan's wife is Naj. We denote husband-wife relation with plus. So there is Naj, Karan's wife. And has daughter Naksha. There is one daughter of Naj and Karan, that is Naksha. So just denote this with help of circle. Naksha got married with Nisha's son Akbar. So Naksha got married. There is one son of Nisha and name is Akbar and Naksha is married with Akbar. So let me denote with plus sign and has baby girl Riya. So they have baby girl Riya. So let me denote in circle, that is Riya. What is the relationship between Naksha and Nisha? We know that Naksha is daughter of Karan and Naj and Nisha is sister of Karan. It means Nisha is aunt of Naksha. So there is relationship of niece and aunt. So answer must be B here. So let me write down niece and aunt. So our answer is B. With help of this family tree chart, we will be able to get this answer easily without any confusion. So this is our answer. Just practice these type of questions. Here is the question on coded blood relation. So in this type of question, I always recommend to write down these signs over here, like multiply denotes sister, plus denotes father, minus denotes mother. Let me write down these all over here. And then let's see the question. Which of the following means S is aunt of T? So to denote the relationship of S as aunt of T, so there must be generation gap. We understood by this criteria that there must be generation gap of S and T, as we want to denote this with as aunt of T. So let's see, S is aunt, it means she is female. So all these all those signs which are denoting that these are sister or mother can be after this S. So there can be minus sign or multiply sign. So if any option is given with plus sign, that is of male, that is father, so we will cancel that, eliminate that in this step. Okay, in coded relation we are going to eliminate all those options which are not possible. So there is one more option which is having no sign after S, because after S we require some sign to get the answer. We should know which gender it is. S is male or female, we can't assert from this point, so we will cancel that as well. So we have two options with us to solve, B and D. Let us solve B first. According to B, S multiply means sister of M, S is sister of M, and plus T, plus means father, M is father of T. Here we can see that M is brother of S, it means S is aunt of T. So we can clearly see that S is aunt of T with help of this option and with help of this family tree diagram. So this must be correct. So B is correct answer. Let us see D as well. There is no need to solve this because we got the answer. So let us consider this. S is sister of M and plus means father. M is father of R. M is father of R. Minus means R is mother of T. R is mother. Mother means circle of T. So there is two generation gap between S and T. So we can't say that S is aunt of T because this relation is going towards somewhat grand. So we can't say about this one. So our answer must be B, because in this B option we can clearly see that S is aunt of T. So answer must be B. Question number 7 says, which of the following means M is grandmother of N? We are asking about the grandmother of N. It means there must be a relationship of two generation gap. So I just wrote these things as dollar denotes father, asterisk denotes mother, and at the rate denotes wife. So let us see. M must be grandmother. Grandmother means M must be female. So there must be some generation gap of two. There must be one person in between M and N to denote this M as grandmother. So M must be lady. So she can be the sign after this M must be in this asterisk or at the rate. So all options are given with asterisk. So we have to solve all of them. So let us consider A. M multiply R means M is mother of R. Then dollar means father. R is father of T. Then at the rate means wife. T is wife of N. It means T plus N. T is wife, so N is automatically male, that is husband of T. So this is the relationship here. If we can see, then M is not grandmother, so this can't be possible over here, because as per this relation, M is in-law of N. Okay, so mother-in-law, grandmother-in-law. So according to B, M is mother of R. At the rate means wife. R is wife of T, and again at the rate of N. So this is not possible in any case, because one person cannot have two wife or something like so. So this is absolutely wrong here. So this relationship is not possible because it's not following logically. Let us see. C. M is mother of T. M is mother of T. Dollar means father. T is father of N. Then dollar means N is father of R. So if we see here, so N is a grandson of M. So it means M is grandmother. So this option is following logically, so that means it is correct. Let us see D as well. M is mother of T. Is mother of T. Dollar means father. T is father of R. At the rate means wife. R is wife of N. So again here it can't be possible. So D answer is not possible. We can clearly see that C option is correct. So it is correct as per our family tree. Let us see 8th question. Pointing to a lady, Arun said, the son of her only brother is the brother of my wife. It means there is the lady and Arun is pointing toward this lady. The son of her only brother. It means there must be one brother of that lady. Let us denote this with box. There is brother of that lady. Is the brother of my wife. My wife means Arun is talking about himself. There is one son of her only brother. So there must be son of that brother, and that son is brother of Arun's wife. There is wife of Arun and there is Arun. So we denote this husband-wife relationship with plus. So Arun plus his wife, and there is brother of his wife. So how that brother how the lady is related to Arun. It means that person is father of Arun's wife. Father of Arun's wife is father-in-law of Arun, and sister, that lady is sister of his father-in-law. As per this, we can clearly say that that lady must be sister of Arun's father-in-law. So D must be the correct answer here. So let us correct this D. Let us see another question. This is upon E is the son of A. E is son of A. So A is father of E. So we do not it like so. D is son of B. Again, D is son of B. E is married to C, and there is C who is married with E. So we can clearly say that E is male, then C must be female. C is daughter of B. C is again daughter of B. We can say that here B is father of C. How is D related to E? We can see that this D is son of B. We can clearly see D is son of B. So if B's daughter is C and B's son is D, so there must be brother and sister relationship. How D is related to E? D is brother of his wife. So it means brother-in-law. So D must be correct answer here, brother-in-law. 10th question is about again coding and decoding. Just write down all these symbols. At the rate is for father, plus denotes husband, dollar denotes brother, percentage denotes mother. Let me write them. Percentage denotes mother and denotes sister. Now let's solve the question. Question says, which of following option definitely true if expression A plus B and C at the rate, this is the expression, and which of the following is definitely true? There is no any chance of being wrong in the question. So that we are going to search for definitely true. So question is saying A plus means husband. A must be the husband of B. So we denote this husband-wife relationship with plus, and B must be lady then, and means sister. So B is sister, let me denote with minus, of C. At the rate means father. C is father of D, let me denote this with help of arrow for generation gap. Percentage is for mother, mother of E, and dollar is for brother. It means E is brother of F. Brother sister denote by minus sign. Then let us see, A is uncle of E. A is here, and uncle means this can't be possible because there is gap of two generations. B is aunt of D. B is, yes, aunt of D, because this is C's sister. B is C's sister and aunt of D. So C, second answer can be possible and perfectly, definitely possible. So let me correct this second option over here. Let us see another. E is sister-in-law of A. There is A, and E is sister-in-law, can't be possible because this is downward relation, so can't be possible. E, F is daughter-in-law of C. There is no husband-wife relation with F, so can't be possible. C is uncle of A, so it is not possible because he is not uncle. C is brother-in-law of A. So that is not possible. Let me cut this. So we have our answer. Second option is absolutely correct. What should come in place of question mark? There is coding decoding, that to missing coding decoding blood relation question. Make relation R is the aunt of C. So we have to make the relationship of R as aunt of T. Let us consider this. P percentage means mother. P must be mother circle of Q. Generation gap mother, and then Q plus means husband of R. Q is husband of R, and means sister. So R is sister of S. Let me write down with minus sign. as question mark t. Then to make this r aunt of t, we have to give the generation gap over here for t. So there must be generation gap between r and t. Let me draw the arrow over here for generation gap. This is t. Now let's see which type of relationship of S must be. S must be father or mother of T, so that we this can make R as aunt of T. So there must be father is at the rate and mother is for percentage. So either at the rate or percentage, it means third option must be correct over here. So let me correct this. Now we come to question number 10C. How T is related to Q in expression. So let me draw this expression first. We are going to check out for the Q and T relationship. P at the rate means father of Q, and percentage means mother of R, and means sister. R is sister of S, plus means husband. S is husband of T. Box for T, and then T must be the woman, female. Okay, then let us see what is the relationship between T and Q. Let us see, Q is mother of R. It means Q must be mother of S as well, because there is brother sister relationship. Then if she is mother of S, and wife of S must be daughter in law, so there is mother-in-law and daughter-in-law relationship. So that must be first answer, daughter-in-law. So we are able to solve all these questions, all 12 questions. So please do solve such type of questions on blood relation, and then tell me how you are able to solve them. Is it easy for you or not? So for this previous lecture, you just visit the link in description box and visit that previous lecture to be more clarified and get this concept clearly. If you want to get these notes, then notes link is also given in description box. Next test is on Wednesday for research aptitude, so don't miss that at 10 p.m. Keep watching Nav Classes. Please do subscribe if you didn't yet, and share my videos with your friends. If you click on Nav Classes, you will reach to my channel. Here is bell icon with subscribe button to get notified. You just click on this bell icon. Here under video section, you will get all my videos over here, and under playlist, you will get all playlists as per your requirement in English or Hindi. Thank you.